Welcome to the Inquendo Guitars Workshop. And if you're working on guitars, building them, changing strings, doing setups, you might want to use a neck rest. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to make your own neck rest just using basic tools most likely everyone is laying around the house. So here we go. When building guitars, you always end up with these strange looking offcuts from the side of the body, and this section makes a perfect piece of wood to make a neck rest out of. But if you don't make guitars and you're only interested in making your own neck rest for setups and chasing strings, you can of course use any piece of wood you like. Make sure it's fairly thick. I use a minimum of 45 millimeters, so it's nice and stable, but you can use any wood you like. And I'm going to use this beautiful piece of black limba to make a new neck rest. So let's take a look at the tools I'm going to use. So the tools you need for this project is a jigsaw, and if you have access to a bandsaw, by all means use a bandsaw. It cuts much easier, but I'm going to do this with a jigsaw, so anyone can do this. Good quality jigsaw blades, square and a ruler, some rasps and files, of course pencil and an eraser, compass, a little knife, some contact adhesive, and I'm going to use a contact rubber, a flexible adhesive, masking tape, not really, a couple of round things to draw circles around, and of course some sandpaper. So let's draw out the shape of the neck rest, first starting by drawing in a center line. I want my neck rest to be around about 80 millimeters high, so draw out 80 millimeters. And I want my base to be around about 20 centimeters, so 200 millimeters wide. So I've set my compass to around about 100 millimeters, but I can't fit the point, so I'm going to use the second piece of wood, elongate my center line, and now I can place my compass like so, and draw in the outside shape of the neck rest. I want these, let's call it feet, to be 50 millimeters wide. So on one side, 50 mils, using the same center point, adjust my compass. And here's my second semicircle, half a circle. And for the top part, I want there to be at least 25 millimeters of material between the bottom circle and where the top part of the neck rest is going to be. So using the inside and draw in this part, and it's you have to eyeball it, or if you have enough material here, maybe you can use a compass. I have plenty. I can use my compass to draw in that shape as well. If you don't have enough material left over at the top, you can always find something round to determine this circle. Let's start using the jigsaw to cut this out. When doing this by hand, it's a good idea to have your design on each side of your piece of wood. So I've drawn out the design on one side, used my square to take these marks to the other side of the wood, and did exactly the same on the other side. So now I have my design on both sides as a reference. Before you start cutting with the jigsaw, clamp your workpiece to a working surface or to your bench. And when using a jigsaw to cut thick pieces of wood, thick pieces of timber, it's wise to make some relief cuts, somewhat square to the bottom and up to the line of the curve you want to remove. I've got a very terrible quality, very cheap jigsaw, and I can't cut the curve in one go. The blade will bend, although it's a very sturdy blade. So I like to cut these relief cuts. And it's always a good idea to cut this from both sides. Don't go all the way around in one go, but go from each side. So here's the first cut done, and as you can see, I had some blade twist or blade wandering on one of the cuts, so I have to clean this up using some rasps and some files. But first I'm going to cut out the other shapes. Here's our rough shaped neck rest, and now it's time to clean up all the marks and the miscuts made by the jigsaw using rasps and files, of course. And yeah, a jigsaw isn't the best tool for this job, but it's a tool most of you most likely have. The better job, of course, is using a bandsaw, and instead of using rasps and files, you can just use a spindle sander to do this job much quicker, much easier, and more accurate. But I wanted to show you that even with the most basic tools, it is feasible to do this in your own, yeah, maybe even in your kitchen. Let's start filing and rasping to get a nice and smooth result. Up all the cavities or recesses I just cut out, and I added another position in the bottom two legs of the neck rest using files, rasps, and sandpaper. I already started sanding the neck rest, and now I'm going to make sure there are no sharp edges anywhere left on the neck rest. The last thing you want if when you accidentally hit your neck rest with the neck of a guitar, that your guitar neck might be dented in the worst case scenario. So I'm going to sand the entire neck rest, starting with 60 grit, going up the grits, 120, 180, 240 perhaps, 380, and then it's time to put on some finishing touches. The neck rest is all sanded and almost ready for the final touches. Sometimes it can rock just a little when you set it on a flat surface. And if it does, just take a sheet of sandpaper, put it on the flat surface, and just give it a couple of passes with very light pressure until it doesn't rock anymore. And now it's nice and stable and ready for the final touches. I'm going to use this black foam rubber to glue in all the rounded sections, and I went ahead and I cut a strip already just a little wider than the actual neck rest. In my case, I cut it out at 50 millimeters width, and I'm going to cut out some sections to fit in all the cavities, and I don't have to be that precise because I'm going to trim them later on. So here I've got all my sections prepared to glue in, and I'm starting with the bottom one. I've got my glue, and it's a clear blue. And the main benefit of this adhesive is it stays flexible. You could use super glue, but you can end up with hard, sharp sections in the foam rubber. Use a little comb to spread it and stick it on. And before trimming the excess, I let it sit for a couple of minutes to cure. So now I'm going to do the other side. And let it cure for a moment, trim off the excess, glue in the other two sections, and we're done. So all the foam rubber is glued to the neck rest, and I've trimmed off all the excess. And the nice thing is you can sand down the edges somewhat using some 240 grit sandpaper, and this also removes some of the excess glue. So it's all nice and flush. Time to put on the last finishing touches, and I'm going to use some regular wood finishing oil and put on several coats to finish it off, to protect it just a little and to make it nice and shiny. Make it look nice. So just a paper towel, and this is no guitar finishing oil, this is just a regular furniture finishing oil, oil care, nothing special. I got this when I bought our dinner table. Just a piece of paper cloth, paper towel, put some oil on it and just rub it in. Maybe just pour it on. So rub off any excess, and you can really buff it in already. Let it sit for 10-15 minutes and repeat the process 2 to 3 more times, and you should add up. You should end up with a lovely finished neck rest. Yeah, see you in a moment. Oh, I almost forgot. For those who are unfamiliar with using oils, there is a chance of self-combustions on the paper towels or the rags you used. So dispose of them correctly. I usually let them dry out, laying them flat down on the floor, letting them dry, or wash them out with water, let them dry before putting them in the garbage bin. Don't boil them up and just throw them out. There is a chance of self-combustion, so keep an eye on your racks. Lay them flat, somewhere to dry, or in a metal bucket or something, until they're completely dried out, and then throw them in the trash. So, see you in a moment. So I let the oil finish cure overnight, and now it's time to put on the final touch. Here is our finished neck rest, all nice and done and ready to be used on a guitar maintenance job, string change, or a new build. Yeah, I hope this video inspired you and helped you to make your own neck rest at home with just a limited amount of tools. And if you like this video, please leave a like, it really helps out a lot. And if you have any questions, suggestions, comments, let me know in the comment section down below. I always try to respond to my comments. Yeah, and if you really liked what you've seen here and don't want to miss out on any of my future content, please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it, and I also want to thank all the new subscribers to my channel. The last couple of weeks have been insane with the amount of new subscribers, and I really, really appreciate the support from you guys. So yeah, subscribe to my channel if you already haven't, and I hope to see you in the next video. But until then, have a nice week.